All right, this is going to be the next matchup. This one is going to be the Los Angeles Clippers versus the Dallas Mavericks. Now, this one's going to be very competitive. Now, the Clippers did lose 2 days ago. You know, they lost the basketball game. They do lose basketball games that they were supposed to win. Like, they lost to the Phoenix Suns. You know, I said, wrong basketball team. I must be tripping today. I said that the Phoenix Suns would lose and that the Los Angeles Clippers should win. Unfortunately, that's life. You're not always right. And that's a prime example. I'm not always right because there'd be this one person who come in the comment section and be saying, you got this one wrong, and I'm going to say it again in all my videos. I don't always get this stuff right, okay? I get 60 to 80% of the statistics correct. All I do is talk about sports on this channel. So if it ain't pertaining to sports, I don't want to hear it. You start talking about stuff that's not sports related, you start talking about stuff that's not basketball, football, baseball, boxing, mixed martial arts, wrestling. If it ain't sports related, I'm just going to ignore your comment. So it better pertain to sports. It better be about basketball, football, baseball, professional wrestling, boxing, mixed martial arts. It better be sports pertaining. All on this channel, all we do is talk about sports. And I have an idea for a sports documentary to explain why I say what I say. But this is going to be a competitive basketball game, okay? Nobody is surprised at this. This is going to be a competitive basketball game. Now, I think the Clippers should win this game. Now, in the last game, Kawhi Leonard started playing late. And I think that's an indication that if the playoffs was to start right now, the Clippers' defense would collapse. The backcourt would collapse. And the coach would have to call timeout too many times. So if they don't fix those minor adjustments and they don't try to learn from 2 days ago when they lost to the Phoenix Suns, they're going to lose tonight's basketball game. Because I have a feeling Dallas Mavericks might actually win this game. And they might lose 2 games in a row 3 days later, and you might be scratching your head saying, how is this the best basketball team in the West, and they're better than the Lakers, and you lost to the Phoenix Suns. And if you lose to the Dallas Mavericks tonight, that's going to make people wonder that if the playoffs was to start today or tomorrow, could the Clippers make the minor adjustments? Now, it's unfortunate that Lou Williams is not 100%. You know, we already heard about that debacle. It's not sports related. I don't want to hear it. Paul George had a game where he was up and down. His minutes, his production went down in the last game. So if they don't fix these minor adjustments today, they're going to lose to the Dallas Mavericks. I mean, yeah, they could have a high-scoring game. They could play with this game for 4 quarters. But based on what I saw in the last game, I did not like what I saw from the Los Angeles Clippers. I was actually disappointed that they lost to the Phoenix Suns because Kawhi Leonard waited until the third and the fourth quarter to start playing his game when he should have just played it from the very beginning. That's another issue I have with some of these premier NBA players. Stop waiting until the third and fourth quarter to play your game and play your game in the beginning when the game starts, because you get late behind, you're 15, 20 points behind, Dallas Mavericks is going to keep you behind. Because Dallas's mentality is to win as many basketball games as they can because they want their name in the conversation, okay? They want to be in the conversation with the Lakers. They want to be in there with the Thunder, the Clippers, the Houston Rockets. They want to be in that conversation. And the way you get into the conversation is you beat a team that everyone picks to win the NBA championship. You know, they beat the Clippers, then everyone's going to be saying, can Dallas do that to the Lakers, or can they do that to the Thunder? And they beat the Clippers today. That's called making a statement. So I would be nervous right now because they should have not lost to no Phoenix Suns, and they did. The game felt flat. I didn't know if that was a basketball game or if that was practice. Now, they said they needed more games to get themselves together for chemistry, but the playoffs is coming real soon. And if you don't fix the adjustments today and you still have the same problem, then when the playoffs come, you're carrying those inefficiencies into the playoffs. Then you get exposed. Then they start picking holes at your offense, your defense. They find out that you can't play that very good in the backcourt. So what they lost to the Phoenix Suns, they better not make the same mistake here in this game, because Dallas is a good defense team. They're good on offense, and they're good at figuring out how to shut your offense down and make you play defense, and then they're good at making you miss your best shot of three-pointers. So if the Clippers win, it would be 106 to 104. That means it's going to be a close, tight game if they win. Dallas seemed like they have everything going for them very well. No one suspects them to do anything this season. People are shocked that this team is even in the playoffs. I've been looking at some videos. I got to watch them again to see how accurate their prediction is. But people keep thinking Dallas Mavericks going to win the championship. The only way I think that would happen is if they can beat teams like Toronto Raptors or the Bucks. If they can get past Houston, Thunder, or the Lakers. If they can get past the Jazz. If they can get past those teams, then I can see why someone would even come up with that conclusion. The Dallas Mavericks want to win a championship, which I think is way off base. I think people are just excited that they got that one tall player that can do everything. He can score, he can shoot, he can dunk. I got to see more from Dallas Mavericks before I'm 100% convinced that that's the team that's going to take the title. Because people are saying Lakers, Houston, Clippers, Thunder, Jazz. Those are the names that come up 90% of the time. So the Dallas Mavericks win, it could be 104 to 102, a very close, tight game. If there's a blowout, I wouldn't be surprised or shocked. If Mavericks win the game today, I won't be surprised. And if the Clippers lose, it's going to be because they lost to the Phoenix Suns. And like I said, you don't lose to a team like that when you've got Paul George and Kawhi Leonard. They collapsed in that game. And if they do it again today, I wouldn't be surprised. If they win the game, I'm not going to be surprised by the Clippers.